Hey YouTube, this is a free extract from my larger Illustrator course called Illustrator Essentials. You can check it out on bringyourownlaptop.com. If you want to follow along with this video, there's exercise files, okay? Those are free to download. You can go and download those and there'll be a link in the description, okay? So you can play along. One last thing is there's a cheat sheet as well. So there is a PDF you can download from bringyourownlaptop.com. Look for resources, okay? It's a free PDF. You can download it, print it up, stick it next to your computer while you're doing these videos. All right, enjoy the video. Bye now. Hey there, in this video we are going to make the BP flower. We're gonna make one of the petals using ellipses and the curvature tool. Then we're gonna set centers of rotation, spin it around, shape builder tool. It's all very exciting. Let's go and learn how to build that now in Adobe Illustrator. All right, first up, open up our exercise files, okay, and go to logo redraw. There's one in there called 6BP. Open that one up. Okay, so there's a few ways of drawing this. I'm gonna start with an ellipse, draw one of the petals and rotate it around. Seems like the easiest way to do it. Okay, so you might have to hold down the rectangle tool, grab the ellipse tool. And there's a couple of things I need. I kind of want to find out where the center of this thing is. So I'm gonna open up my rulers. We haven't done this before. Let's go to view, go to rulers, and let's go to show. And we are gonna click, hold, and drag in this dark area here to get a kind of an option for the middle. Click, hold, and drag from this dark numbered area here to get a middle about there. Awesome. We'll use them to get started and we'll delete them in a second. So within my ellipse tool, I wanna draw out something that kind of roughly looks like. It's gonna start from the center, so we might as well connect to that. If yours aren't on, we're gonna turn the smart guides on and off during this class because sometimes they're super useful and sometimes they're not. So view, make sure they're turned on. Okay, black arrow. I'm making sure I've got a fill of none and a stroke of black. I'm making sure the stroke is quite small at 0.25. Now I'm gonna just drag this along. So smart guides now are being a bit of a pain. Okay, so I'm gonna turn them off. View, smart guides. Zoom in a bit. Spacebar, holding down spacebar, clicking, holding, and dragging to move. I feel like the basics are there. I need a little bit wider. Okay, you might have to come back to this stage a couple of times to get it to do what you want. So we're gonna hope for the best. So we've got this kind of rough shape in here. Now we want to kind of convert these to little points. And the curvature tool's really good at it. Looks like the pen tool. It's the curvature tool. And if you click on these guys, double click them. Okay, double click them, turns it from a curve to a corner. Okay, so we might have to make some last minute adjustments. The black arrow, I'm gonna probably move it in a little bit. Use my arrow key, kind of getting it look okay. Spending way too long on it. Hey, I'm not even watching these, so I'm gonna drag these out to match those guys. And I think what's happening here is this thing is actually just, it's not running from the center. Okay, so I'm moving it out, so I'm trying to match the shape underneath. I swear I hadn't practiced this before the class. Anyway, that feels about right for me at the moment. There we go, cool. So I'm gonna select this guide and delete it. It's just dragging a box with a black arrow, deleting them, because they're a good finish now. So now I wanna step and repeat. To rotate this thing around, I need to set the rotation point because at the moment it's rotating around its center. I want it to rotate around that center mark that I just deleted. I'm gonna turn it back. One thing I wanna do is make sure that just this guy here is kind of snapped onto that line there. The way to do it is click off, move it away, grab just this point here and it should snap into the line. Okay, and then I'm gonna move it up just to make sure it's kind of directly on this guide. So next thing I want to do is I want to change my rotation point to this center bit here. Okay, and to do it, grab the rotation tool from your toolbar. Make sure your view smart guides are now on, which is super handy. Okay, because it's gonna kind of find this intersect of the guide. And all I do is hold down the option key on a Mac or the alt key on a PC. This is how to set the rotation for an object. Okay, click it once and that will set the rotation there. Now, next thing we wanna do is work out what the rotation needs to be. Okay, mine's defaulted because I already practiced. Okay, so whatever it is here, it might be something else. Okay, you can drag it around. Now, you can see it's rotating around this point, which is the important thing. What I did was I counted the petals, okay, and there were 18 of them. And then, because my math is so bad, I went 360 divided by 18, okay, and I tabbed out. And it said that is 20 degrees down. I'm like, phew. Okay, and what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna click on the copy button, because at the moment it's just rotating that original. So I wanna click copy, and it, yeah, rotates that. Now we get to do this really cool thing. It says object transform, do that thing again. Transform again, Command D on a Mac or Control D on a PC. See where we're going here? So I'm gonna have smash away at that shortcut and just keep going around until I get 18 of these things. Awesome. Okay, so we're partially there, right? And what we're gonna do now is with the black arrow, select all of these guys, and we need to kind of do some merging and slicing and dicing. First one, we'll do the white ones, they're quite easy. So we're gonna grab the Shape Builder tool, my favorite tool in the world, okay? And with nothing held down on your keyboard, it's this little plus icon, can you see it? Okay, so what I wanna do is kind of like drag a little bit of a loop around here. Oh man, this is gonna be tough. There's lots of stuff in here. Because I basically want to get out to these guys, right? So I'm just kind of dragging across these till I get these outer ones at least. I'll fix the inside ones up in a sec with a different technique. So that joined most of them. What I'm going to do is grab my white arrow, okay, and click in the background and select all of these guys and just delete them. Cool. So we've got the kind of white center. Back to the black arrow, we'll zoom out. And I need the colors now, okay? So I might as well use the colors while I'm working. So I'm gonna steal them first and then apply them. So I'm gonna grab my eyedropper tool, actually black arrow, click in the background, nothing selected. Grab your eyedropper tool, there he is there. I'm gonna click on the green. Over here, go to fill, I'm gonna say you are a new swatch. I'm just gonna click okay, and there he is there, global swatch. Okay, same thing again, click off in the background. Actually no, just eyedropper tool, grab that green. Go back to properties, you and you swatch please, click OK, grab the eyedropper tool which I've already got, click the yellow in there, back to properties, you, I'm gonna add you, so I've got three colors that I'm gonna use. Cool, so I've got my colors, now with it all selected, because at the moment it's not gonna quite work because they're all still kind of like separate chunks, so I'm gonna select them all, black arrow, I'm gonna grab my shape builder tool. Okay, and if I preload my shape builder with a fill color, let's say it is going to be the green, okay, and I just go around, click, 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 click. Okay, I might get this sped up, all right? So I'm just gonna use this technique to go through, fill all the colors, and yeah, let's go the speedy version. All right, and we're back. Okay, so I've gone around and done it. The last thing I might do is select it all and go stroke. You have no stroke. And it's, oh, didn't do it even. Come on, stroke, no stroke, click in the background. And I think it's pretty good. Yeah, it's not too bad, huh? All right, so that is how to redraw the flower from the BP logo using Adobe Illustrator. We learned how to use the curvature tool to kind of change those points from curves to corners. We used the shape builder tool to kind of smash it all into pieces. We even used the direct selection tool to kind of clean up all the junk in the middle. All right, that is it for this video. I will see you in the next one. Hi, what did you think of the video? If you enjoyed it, give me a thumbs up and consider subscribing. Also leave me a comment, let me know what you liked about it. Also, this is kind of a short part of a longer course, okay? If you want to check that out, it's at bringyourownlaptop.com. This is the Essentials course, okay? There is also another course, there is an advanced course, okay, for Illustrator, and also a UI web app design version of Illustrator course as well. Check all those out. Also, it's quite a visual course. I'd love to see what you've actually made. On Instagram, I'm bringyourownlaptop. Okay, check that out. Also remember there's a cheat sheet you can download. Bring your own laptop, it's free under resources. Check all that out and yeah, I'll see you in another video. Bye now.